In this fine tutorial, I will teach you how to make such motion elements for your videos, which you, for example, can use for logo animations like I did here, or as loading bars, flying items, or whatever you would like. Let's head into the work and create this. Let's create a new composition. I'll have a new 5 seconds composition. Please go to the rectangle tool and create a small rectangle in the middle somewhere. I'll come closer with my scroll wheel, I'll hold my shift key, and I'll make a rectangle like that. Now I also need to press Y on my keyboard, select this shape layer, and select this anchor point. I want this anchor point to be in the middle because we'll as well work with the scale, and it will be easier to work with this object if the anchor point is here in the middle. Okay. Now we have this object, and I'll press P, and I'll hold my shift key and press S. P did open position, S did open scale, and the shift key made sure that they will be added above each other. So I have two properties open now. I'll select keyframes for both of them. I click on the little stopwatch and keyframes appear on the timeline. I will go to 1 second and I'll work with the first value of the position. I want this object to travel, well, this amount looks alright. At first I'd have this animation. Boom, nothing fancy. And I see this object is really small, so I'll work with the scale. At first, I want it to be invisible, so I press 0. A few frames forward, I want it to emerge to 130, because it was too small at 100%. Okay, now it's better visible. Let me press V. This object is to about this size, at 130%. As it goes forward, here, I'll press another keyframe. This will be the same 130 keyframe, and here, at the end of the travel line, it should again disappear. So I press 0. Let me maybe make this keyframe a bit earlier so we have more space here, and watch the animation we have until now. Really, really simple. What we can do now is select all keyframes, right click, keyframe assistant, and easy ease them. This will alter the motion a little bit, so the motion is more interesting, but still I would like to have more speed at the beginning. I would like it to swoop around the screen. So I will select the first two keyframes, which are the position keyframes. I'll go to the graph editor, let me select them, and I'll pull this handle forward. This will make the animation at first quicker, and at the end it will slow down. Let's preview that. Okay, the motion is slightly quicker, maybe even a bit more, and here I'll throw it back to the right side, so now it will be really quick, and at the end it will slow down for a little bit. Well, I don't kind of like this motion, I overdone it, so you can always come here, make it back again, and the animation will be a bit different. Okay, I think we have this properly now, and what I want to do now is to pre-compose this object. Why do I pre-compose it? Because I want to shuffle around with it on the screen. And since I have position keyframes open, if I would now shuffle with this, sorry, I selected it wrongly. If I would replace this, a new keyframe would appear and the entire animation would be compromised. So that's why you right click, pre-compose, call it as you want, I'll call it thingy1. And now, since this is a composition, I can grab it, I can fly around with it, and the animation will be always intact. If you want it on the left side, no problem, boom. And now you can have fun with the animation. I click on this, Ctrl D, Ctrl D, Ctrl D, Command D if you are on a Mac, and I'll select the first one. Let me maybe see them where they are. The first one here, the next one here. I'm holding the shift key, so it's precise. The next one here, and I would like to stagger them. So left alt, page down, two times. All right, they are staggered. I see I'm a bit wrong with the first one. Let's make it like that. Let's make the composition closer, and I would have a seamless animation in front of me. Boom, boom. It's kind of like a loading bar or something. You get the idea. I, for example, made recently a logo animation I'm teaching about, and I used the same technique. I made this animation with those objects here, so the entire thing looks more interesting. Preview this animation here. You see, I used the little motion elements to make the animation fly in, fly out, and even I revealed the tagline with the same kind of motion. So this is how you can have some fun and create animations and motion elements like that. My name is Andrzej Pach, I hope you did like the tutorial. If you'd like to see more of such videos, please subscribe to this channel and like this video. This will tell me, yeah, that's a cool video, Andrzej, record more of them. And I'll be happy to do so if you'd like. Thank you very much and see you in the next one.